God bless you, beloved. I am just so excited just to take this moment to speak with you all on today. Those of you that are part of our training for reigning, welcome, and may God forever bless you. Over the past several weeks, both Apostle Knowledge and myself have been just taking the time out to share with you the things of God concerning prayer, intercession, and spiritual warfare, and how all of that affects your overall life. This has been such an exciting time for us, and guess what? We are doing it again. This coming weekend, scores of people from all around the world, just like you, will be with us in a time of spiritual fellowship and prophetic impartation. These training for reigning sessions have been phenomenal, and to say the least, over the top, you know. And as God was just downloading so much information and just as and enabling us to disseminate to you, praise God, the mind, will, and the purpose of God concerning prayer, spiritual warfare, and intercession in the church. And so I believe that this coming weekend will be no exception. You know, somebody said the other day that the journey of 1,000 miles starts with one step. And that one step has now led us several steps closer to helping you to understand and to appreciate exactly, praise God, when Jesus' disciples came to him and said, "Teach us how to pray," just as John taught his disciples to pray. Now you are experiencing that and seeing exactly what that's all about. Apostle Knowledge and I have been teaching, we've been training, and yes, we've been demonstrating exactly what it means to be an intercessor, to be a gatekeeper, to be a watcher, a looker, a prayer warrior in the house of God. And this, my beloved brother and sisters, have been going phenomenally, as I said, very well. Hallelujah. I'm believing right now in this season, in this hour, that as you avail yourself and to being increased with the wisdom of God, the knowledge of God, and the understanding of God, this is going to cause you to be catapulted to another level, to yet another dimension in the things of the kingdom. And so I'm excited. The first night we came in, praise God, amen, we just came in and we started praying and worshiping. Holy Spirit took control. Hallelujah. And we could do nothing but wait and wait and wait and wait until he was finished. Then we went into what we would call the second session, or the second night. Going into that second night, praise God, amen, then the Lord began to speak to us about, amen, the power of the prayer of agreement. And amen, then the third was standing in the gap, what it meant to make up the hedge. And we continued with that. And then going into what was called, amen, elevation in prayer, and how it is and what it means to pray vertically. So many of you will remember that session, and we began to deal with, amen, the reason why so many people are taken out in the line of duty is because they're just praying from left to right or from right to left. I begin to teach you one of, amen, our secrets on how, amen, Apostle and I, how we receive breakthrough every time we go to pray. It's because our prayers are not staying at the same level. But we were teaching you, praise God, how to elevate and escalate in the things of God. Now, you would remember in that first session that even though you went up the steps of that ladder, amen, you met demons, or you met a devil at every level. But, amen, God gave you, amen, the insight on how to overcome that demon or that devil at every level by even introducing you to the supernatural realm of angels. Praise God, amen. So this is an exciting time. In our session 6, we showed you a principle about the hedges, and we showed you what Jesus meant when he said to stand in the gap and to make up the hedge. Well, in our demonstration on this past weekend, we were able to show you how it's okay to be moving along or to have somebody praying for you. But if somebody is missing or out of place, it causes a gap. And that is what makes it difficult for people to receive their answers or breakthrough in prayer. Because why? The intercessor, the prayer warrior, or the person that is supposed to be staying in position on the wall, praying and interceding for them, has moved themselves out of their spiritual place. So these are just some of the things we have been revealing to you. This week is going to even be greater. We're going to be introducing you, praise God, to the full armorage of a soldier. I'm going to be introducing you to something that is called the force field in the spirit. Praise God. And what is this all about? What does this have to do with spiritual warfare? What does it have to do with intercession? What does it have to do, praise God, with your prayer strategies and prayer tactics if you're going to make it in the kingdom? Well, I guarantee you, my brother or sister listening, you're going to wish that you were a part of this session, because what Apostle Nadej and I are going to reveal to you is going to change your life and the life of your family forever. So, amen. Make it your business to be with us this weekend. Join us. Come on, be a part of what God is saying. Be a part of what God is doing. Experience, praise God, the different realms, the levels, the realms, and the dimensions of God through the corridors of prayer. The prayer that we teach here in our ministry, some people testify, they said, prophetess and apostle, we've not seen it like this. We've not experienced it like this anywhere else in the world. And that is because God has given to us a unique gift, a unique, amen, a way, praise God, of teaching and training and revealing the mysteries of God. I promise you, you have not seen anything yet. It's going to be so much better on this weekend. As you would have heard by now, Apostle has sanctioned us to move this session coming up on this weekend to Saturday. And we are so glad that we will be doing it, because we realize and we recognize that, amen, time has been our greatest enemy. And we won't have a problem with that on this weekend. We'll be able to press in a little deeper and be able to personalize our training regimens and routines to get you, praise God, elevated and in some cases acclimated, praise God, to win your battle and spiritual warfare at a higher level. So I look forward to seeing you, praise God, all of you on this coming Saturday. Our early morning prayer will start at 7 a.m. Praise God, that's our prophecy, healing, and deliverance clinic. And right after that, we will go into our, amen, our enclosed session, praise God, with those of you that will be in the training for reigning. Whatever you do, get online right now. Go onto my website, MaddieNaudage.org, and register yourself. Everyone, you must register for this session. Praise God. Maybe you registered for the first session. Maybe you were in the third, the fourth, and the fifth. Well, you need to register yourself to be a part of this new session that's starting on this Saturday. Praise God. I believe, praise God, you know, the word of God says in the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 10 and verse number 3, and it says, even though we walk in the flesh, our warfare is not after the flesh. So what is he saying today? Even though we're in a fleshly body, the fight that we are fighting, it is not a fleshly fight. It is not a physical fight. It is spiritual. So I believe, beloved, as you avail yourself and come and take a seat at our table and come and learn and glean, praise God, at the feet of the apostle and this prophet, I believe that God is going to open your eyes and you will receive spiritual insight, praise God, into your next level of breakthrough and even how to pray better and get results. So, amen. We love you so much. That is the training for reigning army 300 plus. Amen. And I believe this session, of course, is session 7. Hey, session 7, the number of perfection, the number of increase, the number where God reveals himself to the bride. And so I am praying, praise God, beloved, that you will be with us and you will be a partaker of what is happening through the Training for Reigning program. We love you all so much, and we are so grateful that you chose to obey the Spirit of God and to be a part of what God is doing in this season, in this army. He's raising an army in this hour. He's raising, praise God, the bride. He said, I'm coming back for a church that's ready. Praise God. Amen. So you need to learn and to know how to do battle and how to, praise God, amen, win this fight, praise God, in the spiritual realm, praise God, before you can have any manifestations in the physical realm. So I love you so much. Listen, I want you to look out for our little Training for Reigning booklet. I want to get this out to all of you. Praise God. Amen. At some point today, amen, look out for it in your inbox or praise God, in your communication device with us. We want to send this out to you, and it's just a little synopsis telling you about what all we've covered so far, and amen, what we're about to do on this upcoming session 7 on this weekend. Well, listen, I love you all so much, and I pray that God will bless you, that God will keep you, He will prosper you in all of your ways. You will not fail. Remember that. You will not fail. You cannot fail. Amen. By the grace of God, you can only succeed. And so, see you this coming weekend. It's going to be powerful. It's going to be prophetic. Hallelujah. It's going to be astonishing, astounding. It is going to be simply dynamic. Amen. So God bless you. It's Prophetess Maddie Nottage, and I love you so much. I'll see you, praise God, for training for reigning this coming weekend. God bless you. Thank you. Because I want the real thing. I want the true brand, so that we can go and win this war.
This is how you get your breakthrough. Hallelujah. This is how you fight your battle. Hallelujah. This is how you win your battle. Ketabakanabasata.
When you take time to train in godly things, your mind must be renewed. And how do you renew your mind? By training yourself, training it with the Word of God. Coming to sessions like these so that you can train your mind.
Staying at one level,
Jesus.
You are fighting devils at that level.
Yes.
And God said, I want to get you to a higher place.
Yeah.
But even to climb up to the higher place, know that there will be warfare. There will be powers and witches and warlocks. Watch out, watch out, watch out. To reach all the way here, to reach all the, it's gonna be more difficult for him trying to get here. Because the person that's supposed to be in between here and there, they leave the church, you know. They are just defective, or they are distracted. Or are y'all getting what I'm saying?
God has ever brought to this earth.
But we have been aligned so much through these sessions as to the right way to pray.
I was dealing with the spirit of torment and worry, and prophetess located me.
I believe everybody in your family, because you are connected to this altar, something great!